Welcome to Power to Excel with Pastor Sule Emmanuel. The Word of God is life. The Word of God brings power. The Word of God brings revival. The Word of God is God Himself. Jeremiah 15:16 says, "Thy words were found, and I did eat them, for they were unto me the joy and rejoicing of my heart." Be blessed as you listen to Pastor Sule Emmanuel. Get set for the empowerment of a lifetime.
The disciples decided to give him escape. So they put him in a basket and threw him over the wall so he can go somewhere else. Listen, when Saul got to Jerusalem, Saul wanted to be part of the disciples. They said, "No, that we delivered it does not mean you can." Am I talking at all? The same people who gave him escape, "We didn't want them to kill you. That we..." How do they say it? Salutation is not love. Am I talking at all? "And that we gave you escape does not mean you should be part of us." Saul was facing all kinds of persecution in Jerusalem. He did everything to belong. Nobody agreed. But scripture tells me, on a certain day, a certain man called Barnabas came out and said, "I will speak for you." "Saul, don't speak." And the man began to tell the people, "This man had had an encounter with God." And don't forget, at this time again, when he was in Jerusalem, they still planned to kill him. He escaped one place, came to another place. They still wanted to kill him. But for Barnabas, for the appearance of Barnabas, Saul would have been history. Do not forget, almost half of the New Testament was written by Saul. If not for Barnabas, the exploit of Saul would have remained an illusion. A voice had to speak for him. Barnabas was not related to him. Somebody somewhere just said, "I will take the battle. So don't speak. Let me do the defense." And because Barnabas spoke, the disciples accepted Saul to join them. Am I speaking at all? The rejections you are facing, certain places, someone has vowed to help you. Almost the day for your help to manifest, he changes his mind. You need a relevant voice. Acts chapter 5. Write it down now. Acts chapter 5. Peter and the apostles were preaching, declaring God's word from place to place, healing people and delivering. But one day, their mouth seemingly drove rough. There was something they said that made the high priest and his people really offended. And they said, "Today we will kill you." And they made up their mind that day Peter and the apostles were going to die. Nothing was changing their mind. They had made up their mind that today is the end of these ones. But scripture tells me that God raised up a man called Gamaliel, a respected lawyer, doctor of the law, highly reverenced by the people. And Gamaliel stood up and said, "Don't kill them. If what they are doing is not of God, it will not last. But if it's of God, you can't stop it." And because they respected Gamaliel, they let go of the apostles. But for this man, go. Am I speaking at all? Scripture tells me that the brothers of Joseph, they hated him for the love that the father had for him. Joseph's problem was not complicated, but Joseph did not have a polite way of talking about his dream. Am I speaking at all? "Just met your elder brother, you will worship me." "Are you thinking at all? Isaac, you think that one is even small? Even my father and my mother, they will worship me." Am I speaking at all? His problem was not that he didn't have a good character, but everything God tells him, he says it, you know, just the way he heard it. Every picture that God reveals, he declares it as, you know, just how he saw it. And Genesis 37, the brothers plotted to kill him. They had made up their mind that today is his unlucky day. He's going to die today. And as Joseph approached, the host said to themselves, "Here comes the dreamer. Let's not let him go today." They all said to themselves. But the God of destiny had to spur the mind of one. And Reuben said, "No, let's not kill him." Don't forget, initially, they all said, But the God of destiny said no. Reuben speak against them. And one man spoke and the nine listened. And that's how the life of Joseph was spared, to fulfill the destiny that he was born for. So do not tell me that the curse cannot be altered. Do not tell me that the condition, the verdict cannot be changed. All you need is a voice to speak for you. Am I speaking at all? All you need is a voice that will speak for you. John chapter 1. John the Baptist, I think from 26 down to 36. John the Baptist had a flourishing church. He was the most popular preacher in town. Listen carefully now. Most popular preacher in town. Pastor John the Baptist was respected by everybody, reverenced by everybody. But John the Baptist decided to promote Jesus. Jesus had not started his apostolic church there, his apostolic ministry, his ministry of signs and wonders. He had not started then. But John took upon him the responsibility of advertising Jesus. John was comfortable enough to say that this young boy whose church has not started is greater than I am. John was comfortable to say these words to his followers. He said, I am not the Messiah. There is one who is coming. The latchet of his shoe, I am not fit. Am I speaking at all? A voice. Hear me well now. Ministry, I believe the starting of Jesus would have had some issues if not for John. The starting, the respect that John had earned, the honor that John had earned, John transferred it to the ministry of Jesus. So which means when a man enjoys the backing of a divine voice, your result is in triples. Am I speaking at all? You don't get the kind of result your mates get. Am I speaking at all? When there's someone that God has troubled to keep singing your name, talking about your matter, you need a voice. You need a voice. 1 Samuel chapter 19. There was a boy called David, highly hated by Saul. Saul hated David with a passion. David was the number one enemy. What was David's problem? Saul hated David because God was behind David. Saul hated David because he had lost God. Am I speaking at all? David was the new location of God. Saul was the ex location. So that brought strife. Saul told his people, he said, when you find him, kill him. Make sure you erase him. Saul told his son Jonathan, he said, this boy is a rival. If we don't silence him, you can't become a king. But when a voice is raised by God to speak for you, a man can sacrifice his place for you. And Jonathan looked at his father. He said, what has David done wrong to you? Why do you want him dead? And 1 Samuel 20 verse 4. Jonathan approached David and said, see, my father may hate you, but ask me anything you want, I will do it. It became so bad that Saul had to curse Jonathan. Placed a curse on him. Insulted the way he was born. Abused the mother that gave birth to him. But Jonathan did not care. Jonathan covenanted with David. David would not have fulfilled his assignment if not for Jonathan. At all times that Saul planned to kill David, Jonathan will reveal it. He said, David, don't go there today. He wants to kill you. And the plot is there. Go this way. I will tell you when to escape. I will throw a sign. And when you see the sign, take this way. But for the appearance of Jonathan, but for the divine backing of Jonathan, David will not have been the great King David we all hear about. When God decides to help you, he raises a voice in your favor. When God decides to hear your crying, decides to hear your prayer, he troubles someone to take your matter on his head. I'll say that again. If you think you can succeed by your sweat and your struggling alone, you may die trying. If Jesus needed people to fulfill destiny, what about you? If Jesus needed a voice to fulfill divine assignment, what about you? That's why scripture says, where there is no vision, the people perish. And where there are no people, the vision will perish. So no matter how great a dream you have, no matter how great your dream, if there are no people, the dream will perish. You have so many people who have great concepts. They can write the best of computer programs, software programs. They can design the best of technological machines. They can do all kinds of things. Give them the resources. They can even produce small cars. But the difference between them and Mercedes, the difference between them and Toyota is a voice. Am I speaking at all? The greatest of footballers we see today, whose name are everywhere, they are not the best of footballers in the world today. Majority of the greatest footballers ever born are in the rural areas. Nobody to speak for them. Nobody to recommend them. Nobody to just say, I know of this guy, put him in your club, everything changes. A voice. Hello, sir. Even if you are not competent, if a good voice speaks for you, you get the job. Am I speaking at all? No. How can a president recommend you for a job? Even if what you studied is history and they put you in an engineering position, is the president.
We believe that the wonders of God's word has begun. Your life will never remain the same as you make a commitment to practice everything you have heard. Please kindly share your testimonies with us so we can thank God with you. For additional information about Omega Fire Ministries, please call 011-042-7976. Send us your prayer requests on omegasouthafrica@gmail.com. Please worship with us every Sunday by 9 a.m. at the Land of Increase, Omega Fire Ministries, 310 Oak Avenue, behind Randburg Square, beside Absa Bank, Ferndale, Randburg, South Africa. Or you can visit our website at www.talkwithsuleimanuel.com. We look forward to finally having you join this happy family.